You are listening to the Hiking Radio Network, where we talk the walk with shows by hikers about hikers for everybody.
Welcome to the Trail Dames podcast, where we speak with women who love to dance upon this earth. Hey everyone, welcome back to the Trail Dames podcast. If you've been listening for a while, I hope you've been enjoying my Appalachian Trail journal entries. I've been sharing with you tales of my own attempt at a through hike. Well, you might remember I mentioned several times my awesome friend, Jan Leitschuh. Leitschuh was a horse whisperer who one day got bitten by the AT bug, and she hiked the same year I did. And while she was doing her hike, she kept an extraordinary journal. She never published that journal, but she gave me permission to share it with you here on the Trail Dames podcast. The stories will come back in the future. But now for the next few months, I want you to take a trip on the AT with Leitschuh. She experiences every second of her hike with depth and with wonder, and she shares it beautifully. I know you're gonna love it. My name is Anna. All my friends call me Mudbutt. And today I'm introducing you to my friend Leitschuh. Thanks for listening to the Trail Dames podcast. Leitschuh's Appalachian Trail Journal. May 29th, 2002. Well, okay, so it appears I'm going to tackle this thing, this 2,172.6-mile mountain wilderness walk from Georgia to Maine. Why walk the whole Appalachian Trail? It's an enormous, uprooting 6-month project. Everyone wants to know why. I'm embarrassed to say I know some reasons, but I'm not fully sure of them all. See, when things are going well, there is a momentum, if you will, to stay put. I love my town of Southern Pines, and it has been very good to me. I have prospered here for the last 6 years. I love my work, teaching, and training horses. Backpacking is, well, hard. That's why no one was more surprised than me when this hike emerged. There was one moment when it all shifted. My mother died in December of 2000 after a long illness. This is one of life's classic checkpoints. I didn't know it then, but the journey had begun. Then, another pivotal event. The very next month, January 2001, I read this book, There Are Mountains to Climb by Jean Deeds. She's a 50-ish year woman, walks the Appalachian Trail alone. And I thought, I'm not yet 50. Now, I read hundreds of books in a given time, yet somehow something in Deeds' account penetrated deeply. Within days, I was waking up in a cold sweat thinking, but I don't know how to work a camp stove. I own no tent or pack or, insert many, many gear accoutrement. I'm not strong enough to carry a pack up mountains. Besides, I'd rather eat dirt. I can't do it alone, and no one will go with me. It's hard. I can't disrupt my comfortable life like this. I'll go broke. I'll have to give up my coveted farm lease. My clients will abandon me. I'll lose professional status. Or my personal favorite, you're gonna freeze out there. And then I would come fully to consciousness, sweet relief flooding my body. Oh, you were just dreaming. You're safe at home. You just read a book. You're not really walking the Appalachian Trail. Phew, what a relief, eh? Isn't it funny how sometimes our minds are the last to know? Beneath the surface, all sorts of plans are bubbling up from the cosmic murk. And then the brain has to scramble to play catch up and eventually claim these happenings for its own credit. So when I say I am going, who is that really? Which eye is casting off the bow lines and sailing out from the safe harbor? The one that decided to go? Or the one that woke up in horror at the very thought? One thing I realized, it sure wasn't my head that launched this endeavor. Though I must say, as of this writing, my brain is caught up and is largely on board. Well, except for those nagging worries like, what are you doing? You are not 20 anymore. Backpacking? Yuck! Plus, what do you know about backpacking? Nada! You're committing professional suicide. Your brother thinks you're nuts. Are you? You're gonna die, dash starve, dash get buried, dash bust something expensive. And of course, for God's sakes, at least wear clean underwear. Ha! See, our mothers live on in us after all. Following January's Jean Deed book reading came a series of interesting coincidences. In February, I ran into my neighbor, Laura Gingrich, to learn that she was about to set off on an Appalachian trail hike with her two teenage sons. Hey, someone I know is hiking this thing, and a woman too. Energy. It can be done by real people. The next month, March, who shows up in my barn at my horse training business looking for work but Wendy, a.k.a. Philosophy Cronkite, class of AT 2000. Another thru-hiker? Get out! Bear in mind that up to this point, I had never met a thru-hiker before. So every morning, instead of jumping right on my first horse, I was pestering Wendy with questions. What do you eat? Answer, gross stuff you wouldn't eat at home. How far did you walk? Sometimes as much as 25 miles a day, but mostly less. Were you scared, dash lonely, dash uncomfortable? No, no, and yes. The next month, April, under the guidance of this AT guru extraordinaire, I had all my equipment. All of it. This still amazes me, the speed at which I became educated, equipped, and ready to roll. The fine points of gear made my head swim. I remember my first trip to the outfitters with Wendy. I was totally overwhelmed. All the choices and unfamiliar stuff. Yet, I learned. I chose. And also in April, I persuaded Wendy to take me and a neighbor, Debbie, out on the Appalachian Trail backpack. That incredible week changed the course of my life. Though Wendy suggested we turn back due to snow, equipment failure, and rapidly falling temps, I decided to push on, alone. I didn't even have enough warm clothes. Stupid. As I informed expedition leader Wendy of my decision to keep walking, I expected her to talk me out of it, but she never did, damn it. Instead, she gave me her guidebook, ha! So off I trudged into the snow and freezing wind with my brand new pack, alone. How unlike me. I had to confront a lot of stuff that hike, my fears of being alone, worries about being far, far away from help, anxiety at being left behind as stronger hikers passed by and disappeared into the forward horizon. My fears of the unknown? I didn't even know what a double white blaze meant. I had never even seen a shelter. My fears of being unable to climb a mountain. And I discovered a whole new Jan, someone I'd never met before. And there was another element to this week. Now, maybe the primary thing I am out in search of. A sense of awe. Maybe this is the essential answer to why. That April hike, when the wind screamed and stole my warmth, and I learned how to bundle against the powerful gusts, I felt it. Every sheltered lee brought a sense of gratitude. And yet, I didn't freeze. That first trip, in the quiet of the lees, I could actually hear the snowflakes falling through the hemlocks. Silence. I recalled that same subtle ticking snow sound from childhood. Who hears that anymore? The snow seemed lit from within. There were bears out here and hypothermia-inducing cold. I didn't know where I was going, just following the white blazes on the tree, blindly. The mountain was the boss and I wasn't. That was made abundantly clear. I was at the mercy of larger forces. Even the shrill bravado of my brain was forced to acknowledge it. And somehow, It was a kick, exhilarating. There it was, that sense of being shaken up, of being entirely expendable, of being just where I needed to be, of abundance, of deep nourishment, of wholeness. So, yeah, I'd like more, please. Bring it on. Even if it does mean lugging a heavy blankety-blank pack up a mountainside over and over again in the rain. Best to surrender to the tides and see where they take the ship. Casting off. See what I mean? Isn't her writing fantastic? Like I mentioned, she hasn't published these journal entries, and I just really appreciate her sharing them with us. But you know what she has done? Before she did her AT through hike, she did a through hike of the Vermont Long Trail, and she did write a book about that. It's called The Ordinary Adventurer, Hiking Vermont's Long Trail, a Primer for Baby Adventurers and Other Musings on the Nature of the Journey. You can find it on Amazon. I have put the link in the show notes, and I hope that you will go and order it because it is wonderful. I want to say a quick thank you to Steve, aka Mighty Blue. He's our fantastic producer. He is also the creator of the Hiking Radio Network. If you're enjoying the Trail Names podcast, definitely go check out the network. All the podcasts there are wonderful. And if you are enjoying our podcast, do me a favor. Share it with your friends and family. Share it on your social media. We want to get the word out about the Trail Names podcast so we can help inspire women to get out and hike, hike, hike. My name is Anna. All my friends call me Mudbutt, and I really appreciate you listening. Now go hit the trail.